Hi guys, welcome to our channel. Today's session I am going to discuss about 8086 microprocessor program. It's related to transferring the data from source point to destination point in reverse. So reverse order. You take the input values from the specified memory location. Here I am taking 8 memory location for storing the input value. The address location is 2000Hz to 2007Hz. Here storing 8 8-bit values. So after execution of this program, the input value is transferred to output memory location in reverse order. The result starts from 08, 07, 06, 05, 04, 03, 02, 01. So in this order, the data is transferred from source point to destination point. How the data is transferred from source to destination, that we discussed with the help of this program. Now I am going to explain the sequence of the program. The first instruction is move SI, 2000Hz. So initially, you pick the input memory location. The input memory location is 2000Hz. This memory location is transferred to source index register. So this instruction refer move SI, 2000Hz. This 2000Hz is a immediate data, 16-bit immediate data. So after execution of this instruction, this data is transferred to SI. This 2000 is transferred to SI. Now source index value 2000Hz. Then you initialize the destination index memory location, move DI, 2008. This 2008 is also a 16-bit immediate value. So after execution of this instruction, this 16-bit immediate value is transferred to DI. Now destination index value is 2008Hz. The third instruction move CX, 0008. So this instruction referred how many data is transferred from source point to destination point. So in this program, I am taking 8 values. So 8 values transferred from source point to destination point. So after execution of this instruction, this 0008, it's the immediate value. This immediate value is transferred to CX register. Now CX value is 0008. So for first you initialize the source index register value, destination index register value, then count of numbers. So how many numbers you transfer from source point to destination point. Then add SI, 07. So this instruction is used to change in the reverse order. So starting address location of SI is 2000. So after adding 07 plus SI, you can get the memory location 2007. So the starting address of the source index is 2007 after execution of this instruction. So now SI value is 2000 plus immediate value 07. Just adding these two content, you can get the result 2007. So this 2007 is a new memory location. So the result is stored in SI. Then move AI, within bracket SI. So within bracket, any register mentioned, you can access the memory location. So here SI value is 2007. So after execution of this instruction, whatever value present in the memory location 2007, that content is transferred to AI register. So here 2007 is a memory location. So in this memory location, it holds the 8-bit data. So the data is 08. 08 is a data. This data is stored in the memory location 2007. So after execution of this instruction, this 08 is transferred to AI. So after execution of this instruction, now AI content is 08. Then move DI, AL. So here DI value is within bracket. Within bracket, any value stored, that value is considered as an address location. Here DI is 2008. So already we have declared the destination index memory location 2008. So in this memory location is stored the data from AL. So AL content is 08. After execution of this instruction, this 08 is stored in the memory location 2008. Now 2008, it holds the data 08. Then decrement SI. So before execution of this instruction, SI value is 2007. So after execution of this instruction, just decrement the SI register content. Now this value goes to 2006. software execution of this instruction, SI value goes to 2006. Increment DI. So increment the DI value. Next data you can fetch from the source index register, and this data is transferred to DI. Software execution of this increment DI, this value goes to 2009. Then decrement CX. So once the first value is transferred from source to destination, you can decrement the CX register count. So CX value after execution of this instruction, this value goes to 0007. So JN is a represent jump on no zero. So while CX value is 0 or non-zero, whether CX value is 0 or non-zero, you just check. If CX value is non-zero, this instruction is true, it go to up. The program counter is skip the memory location. So here point up, move AL comma SI. Now SI value is 2006. So in this 2006, whatever value stored, this value is 07. So this 07 is transferred to AL. Now AL value is 07. Then move DI comma AL. So whatever value present in AL, that content is transferred to the memory location DI. Now DI memory location is 2009. So in this 2009, record the data 07. Then decrement SI. So after decrement, SI value goes to 2005. Increment DI 200A. Decrement CX. So after decrement the CX register, the value is 0006. Once again you check the CX value. Here also the CX value is non-zero. Condition is true. Again it's go to the memory location up. Move AL comma SI. Now SI value is 2005. So in this 2005 it hold the data 06. 06 is move to AL. Then this AL value is transferred to DI. Now the memory location 200A. So in this memory location it hold the data 06. So once again decrement SI 2004, increment DI 200B, decrement CX 0005. Once again you check the condition. The condition is true, it go to here. Now SI value is 2004, it hold the data 05, move to AL, then AL content is transferred to DI. 2000B, it hold the data 05, then decrement SI, 2003, increment DI, 200C, decrement CX, 0004. Once again, we check the condition. Condition is true, it go to here. SI memory location is 2003, it hold the data 04, AL value is 04 after execution of this instruction, AL register content is 04, then move DI comma AL, so AL value is transferred to DI, 200C, it hold the data 04. Once again you run the loop, decrement SI 2002, 200D. After increment DI, you can get the result 200D. Decrement CX 0003. Then jump on no zero. The condition is true. Once again, go to the loop up. So the instruction is move AL comma within bracket SI. So SI memory location is 2002. So in this 2002, it hold the data 03. So this 03 is transferred to AL register. So after execution of this instruction, accumulator content is 03. Then move DI comma AL. So whatever value present in AL, that content is transferred to DI. So DI memory location is 2000D 200D. So after execution of this instruction, this 03 is transferred to 200D. Then decrement SI. So after decrement, this value is 2001. So increment DI 200E. Then decrement CX 0002. Once again you check the condition. CX value is 0 or non-zero. So non-zero, the condition is true. Once again you go to the label up. Move AL comma SI. So SI memory location is 2001. So in this 2001, the data is 02. So after execution of this instruction, 02 is transferred to AL. So 02. Then move DI comma AL. AL content is transferred to the memory location DI. Here the memory location DI is 200E. After execution of this instruction, 02 is transferred here. Then decrement SI 2000. Increment DI. Then decrement CX. So 0001. Then once again you check the condition, CX value is not 0. So non 0 means condition is true. Let's go to the loop up. Move AL comma SI. So SI memory location is 2000. 2000 memory location, it holds the data 01. So this 01 is transferred to AL. After execution of this instruction, accumulator content is 01. Move DA comma AL. So AL value is 01. After execution of this instruction, so destination index memory location 200F, it holds the data 01. So after decrementing SI, the SI value is goes to 1, F, F, F. Then increment DI. So after increment, the DI content is 02010. Then decrement CX. So after decrementing, the CX register content is 0000. Then JN is a up. Just you check the CX value, whether the CX value is 0 or not 0. Here, the CX value is 0. The condition is false. It executes the next instruction INT 3. So this INT represents for end of the program. So halt the program. So here already it transfers the source index data to destination index data. The corresponding memory location I mentioned here. The corresponding data is right in the specified memory location. 2009, the data is 07, 06, 05, 04. 03, 02 and 01. This is the output result. Here the output result is stored in a reverse order. So here 08, 07, 06, 05, 04, 03, 02, 01. So in this reverse order, the data is stored in a output memory location. I hope you understand the concept very well. If you are not subscribed my channel, kindly subscribe and support us to make lot of videos. Thank you.